Hi and welcome to this video about the Advanced Local Conscious Enhancer Panel version 3 for Photoshop, also known as Alce, which is the Italian word for elk. Have you ever heard an elk call? Next time you are out in the bush, you'll know. Alce is about local conscious, which in turn is about conscious, and aren't we all familiar with this concept? Of course we are. Conscious involves a difference. Example: I am in conscious with my neighbor because his dogs poo where they shouldn't. Different attitude towards private property and manners you should know by the age of 9. You can have contrasting views about food, politics, education, sex, whatever, but in the realm of 2D images where pixels are the only characters that play the game, if you want to spot a difference, you've got to look at pixels' values. And of course I mean the brightness in each one of their channels. So if you look at this tiny little image made of 2 pixels only, there's a lot of contrast because the two guys here are certainly different. Conversely, this other picture, not so right, it's low contrast. Back to more meaningful images, you can build contrast following the same idea, forcing pixels to be different. How do you do? Stretching their values apart, i.e. letting the picture fill the entire available tonal range slots. Example, this image doesn't have any true white and black point. If you push the lightest areas towards white, pull the darkest areas towards black, and let everything else in the middle fall into its own place in the universe, you're going to get more contrast. You're making pixels more different. And we call this global contrast because A, we live in a globalized world, or B, the adjustment acts upon the entire image. Come on! Now, let's say that we want to focus on just a portion of the image, a circle of this particular radius. Same as before, we can inject contrast, pushing the lightest areas towards white and pulling the darkest areas towards black, perhaps not completely, with a grain of salt. We know the trick now much better than the original. But what happens if we now uncover the whole picture? Surprise, surprise, it is a huge mess, and with good reasons. You're feeding the entire image with food that's palatable only for a very peculiar region of it. Bad times. And of course, if you let the circle visit different locations, you'll find out that each one of them benefits from a different adjustment. Moreover, depending on whether the encompassed region is big or small, even the same location may require different adjustment based on the features included in the circle. In other words, localized contrast is a matter of finding a way to make targeted adjustments to image regions of a specified extent all over the place. Easier said than done, especially if you think about literally rolling a circular selection throughout the entire picture, which is not at all how Alce works, but you get the idea. Time to see the panel in action. You have one main parameter, which is, guess what, a radius, that is to say the localness of the contrast boost. If the radius is small, the area of interest is small too, and we talk about a more local, less global contrast. Conversely, if the radius is high, the adjustment is less local and more global. At the extremes, a 1-pixel radius Alce is very much like, and in some circumstances even better than, traditional sharpening. And at a full-scale radius, Alce tends to global contrast. This is the intensity of the effect that you can adjust to taste. My advice, though, is to play with the radius while keeping the intensity at the maximum level. It helps to assess the radius that fits your image and your intents. Then, if needed, you can always dampen the intensity if it looks like too much. And now comes FAQ number 1. What could a fitting radius possibly mean? Take this image as an example. Do we want a large radius, a small radius, or something in between? Generally speaking, the radius must suit the kind of detail you want to boost. This portrait has appealing features that span some large areas. So if you remember the circle of radius whatever thing I told you about a minute ago, it all boils down to finding a radius that resonates with the image features you want to enhance, like so. If you use a smaller radius, it brings to attention tiny features in the skin that are either distracting or plain ugly when boosted, but hey, you'll be the judge. Intensity to taste, I'm loud here, but for demonstration purposes only. In this picture, conversely, the main features are smaller, and so should theoretically be the radius that is going to boost them. Please know that when I mention big or small, I refer to the radius compared to the actual image size. If your starting point is a billboard-sized 300 ppi image thousands of pixels wide, a radius of 10 pixels is a tiny nothing. Downsample to a gallery thumbnail and all of a sudden 10 pixels become quite a lot. Big or small, relativity is a key word. Alche is as easy as it gets in the beginner's hand, but it's a nuclear bomb if you know your channels blending, masks, color spaces, and the entire usual color correction arsenal. I'm not going to cover advanced technique here because there's already a 90-minute specific multi-part HD video series that goes through them in excruciating detail. Check that out here, it is a true retouching masterclass and it's brought to you Alche lovers for free. Yet there's more that I'd like to tell you about Alche right now. As a routine, it is incredibly awesome if you apply it in multiple rounds, increasing the radius and decreasing the intensity. Huh? Yeah, I know. This comes from a technique called octave sharpening. A mouthful, but pretty neat nonetheless. Alche 3 features and automates something equivalent in the local conscious domain. So without further ado, let's press this plus button and a new handler appears. You can drag it and you see that a second radius is set. Mind you, when dealing with multiple radii, auto preview is disabled, so you have to click the run button to check the result. So what's the panel doing? It applies the first radius, which is the smallest one, at this intensity, then on top of it, it runs a second extra Alche round with this other radius bigger and this intensity here. And you see that the result is different and remarkably interesting. You can add up to 4 sliders, and if you want to have them evenly spaced, press the auto button. Middle handlers will be automatically positioned. Move one yourself to break the symmetry or just uncheck the auto for full manual control. You see that the intensities of each round are predefined, but they can be changed according to your taste and tests. Be aware that multiple rounds of Alche can reach ludicrous levels of contrast pretty soon if you keep the intensity high, so my advice is to start low and then just play and have fun. Also note that now the intensity slider's got a new name, it's global intensity. It's basically mixing the multiple round result with the original unprocessed image. Octave Alche, what you want to call it, is a relatively new field. I've done a lot of experiments myself in the past, but it's always been like an advanced technique known and mastered by very few people. The new interface of Alche 3 integrates the multiple rounds routine and makes really easy to test and tweak it, so I'm confident that Octave Alche is now ready for the limelight. You may have noticed, though, that the smallest radius comes first, so all the rounds are applied in an ascending order. This leads to the best results in my opinion, but what if you want to change it? This brings me to the topic of preferences, this button here, where you can define the panel's settings. On top, the default intensities for each round, then the radii order, ascending from smallest to biggest, or descending, the reverse. At the very bottom, live preview that again works only for single radius Alche. Beside preferences, in the footer you can find the product homepage. If you're stuck, here's the manual. It opens a PDF that contains basically what I've told you here, plus it has some real-world examples too. If you need support or just want to say hello, here you can find me. Alche 3 works internally with a C++ plugin which computes the image data with 32 bits precision, and it also works with 8, 16, and 32 bits HDR images on Photoshop from version CC onwards, both Mac and PC. If you want to record Alche into an action for batch purposes, why not? This button does exactly so. I hope you'll enjoy Alche 3. I've worked on a lot more Photoshop extensions that you can find here on my website. Thank you for watching and bye-bye.